Hi there, it's Marlene Helema from ImageMaven.com, and in this video I'm going to be talking about new camera jitters. You know, you probably got a new camera recently and you're like, where do I start with this camera? Now, if you're using the same brand of camera as you used previously, maybe you got an upgrade to the camera model, it won't be as hard. But if you've got a brand new system, maybe you've gone from DSLR to mirrorless or a point and shoot to a bigger camera, you're gonna be faced with a lot of like questions like, where do I start? So in this video, I'm going to show you which menus to start with and how to get you started off on the right track. Also, if you are switching systems, you may not be aware of all the new features and how to use them in the new system. So this is a good opportunity to learn all the new stuff. All right, let's get started. The first thing I like to set up is the picture size, and some cameras it's called image size, photo size. It refers to the resolution of the photo when you capture it. So whether it's a medium, small, large, every camera has different pixel dimensions for those. The next thing is quality. So your image quality, picture quality. And if you're shooting JPEGs, always choose the best possible quality. If you're shooting RAW, you can choose that. And you can also shoot JPEG plus RAW at the same time. If you're shooting RAW files, check that you can actually open your RAW files before doing a big shoot. This is the number one problem people have with new cameras. Trust me, I know. The camera raw page on my website is the most visited page in the history of my website. Next, ISO. So I suggest you do the ISO tolerance test. And what that means is you set your camera, say on program mode, and you start with the lowest ISO, perhaps it's 100, and then double the ISO every time and do a picture. So 100, 200, 400, 800, 1600, 3200, 6400 and beyond if your camera allows you. At some point, the digital noise in your file is going to look gross to you. You're not going to like how it looks. That is the point where your tolerance falls apart. You can no longer tolerate pictures at super high ISO. That doesn't mean you can't use those super high ISOs, but use them sparingly because you won't be happy with your results. But sometimes in low light, we have no choice. Okay, aspect ratio is another setting, and not all cameras have this choice, but with Lumix cameras, as you can see here, I can choose from all different aspect ratios, 4:3, 1:1, 16:9, and 2:3. Okay, next, white balance. Now, white balance, typically your camera default is auto white balance. If you are more of an advanced or intermediate photographer, you'd probably like to set your white balance manually. In that case, if it's a sunny day, choose daylight white balance. If you're shooting on a cloudy day, choose cloudy. While you're at it, figure out how to use custom white balance. I always use custom white balance when I'm shooting in the studio. Especially when I'm shooting JPEGs, then I know that my color is bang on and I don't have to worry about adjusting it after the fact. Next, set up your histogram. If you're a histogram user like I am, you'd like to know the exposure levels in your photo. So the histogram will tell you if your exposure is too bright or too dark. You can also set up gamut warnings, so I call them the blinkies, which tells you that parts of your photo are over or underexposed. You can set that up too. Next, you want to look at your photo style. Now, cameras typically have at least 3 or 5 or whatever photo styles. Something like standard, portrait, black and white, vivid color, sepia, those kind of things are what you're going to find in the photo style menu. So just familiarize yourself with where that is and set up the one that you use the most. Also, if you're shooting video, you want to check the video recording format, the frame rate, and the resolution before starting to shoot video. And if you happen to own a 4K camera, so it will shoot 4K video and some also shoot 4K photos, learn how to set that up too. Now, of course, you might not want to do everything right away, but you definitely want to start with your picture size, your quality, your ISO and your white balance just before you go on your first photo walk. A few extra tips. Buy a fast new memory card and format it with the new camera. You want the format to be of the camera make and model and brand that you're going to be using that card with. Yes, you can switch cards without formatting, but you might have problems reading and accessing those files in the future. I suggest brand new camera, brand new card. And one last thing, charge your battery fully before using the camera. And consider getting a spare battery right away too. You don't want to be stuck in the middle of your photo walk and running out of power, because usually when your camera ships, the battery isn't fully charged. If you'd like more information about each of those topics, don't forget to check out all the links in the blog post that goes with this video. So as you probably noticed from the video, we covered a lot of the basics, which I've talked about over and over before. But sometimes when you get a new camera and you've been using digital cameras a lot, you kind of forget about the basics because they're so automatic with your previous camera. My goal with this was to get you started and get you started on the right foot and to start learning that muscle memory. What I suggest is you go and do something fun with your new camera. Go on a photo walk. Maybe have a theme on your photo walk, maybe work with shapes, colors, or use aperture priority for your whole photo walk. Whatever it is you need to do, but try not to have too many variables when you do your photo walk and concentrate on those one or two camera menus or functions that you'd like to learn first. Now, just so you know, there's lots of other resources in the blog post. The link is below. If you're seeing this on YouTube, definitely you want to check out the blog post that goes with this video, because I have more information on all the topics I covered. Thanks so much for watching, and give me a thumbs up, and please subscribe to my YouTube channel. See you next time. It's Marlene Hielema from ImageMaven.com. Happy shooting!